Hi, everybody. My name is Tony Lankford. I'm the executive producer of a television program called The Actors Lounge. Now, let me tell you what The Actors Lounge is. The Actors Lounge is a television show about Philadelphia actors telling us what they do and why they do it. And we also have some great movie trailers of some current movies that are out right now. So what I want you to do is sit tight, and we'll be right back with the show.
Philadelphia. I'm currently in a show, actually out of town. I'm doing a regional show in Cape May called Why Marry. I began acting as a child, really. I did lots of theater, lots of musical theater. I sang opera in high school and then went to college, actually, as a vocal performance major. And took some acting classes just for fun, really. And I'd always loved it. I've always done it. Met a great professor at college who also directs in New York, and he took me under his wing and started coaching me privately, and I ended up spending a semester in New York and just decided after that that I had to act. And, came to Philly, I guess, right after college, and started auditioning for things and done lots of work here in Philadelphia, and I love it. A million reasons. I love it. I love the expression of it. I love the collaboration. I love the potential for a story to breed empathy in the audience. I like the chance to take them on a journey to some place that they maybe have never been before, and they can understand something that they couldn't really relate to before. And I like to entertain. My first part was in college. I played Laura in The Glass Menagerie. Tennessee Williams is one of my favorite writers, playwrights. And my college professor actually directed that show and gave me that part, and then I was seen in that and got cast in other things from that and met some great people in that production that kind of helped me. Well, it's not the easiest thing to do, obviously. There's tons of rejection. You can't expect to get every part, but you can't let that stop you. You know, I may go on 10 auditions and get, you know, 3 callbacks and only get one part or not get any. And there are times when you don't work. There's times when, you know, like after I finish the show this weekend, I don't have anything lined up. And of course that's scary, but you can't stop it. You know, you always have to be committed to it and constantly pursue it and just believe. I think to be a strong actor, one has to really believe in their own talent. Because nobody's just going to hand it to you. Nobody's going to tell you endlessly that, you know, you're wonderful and you're going to get everything. It just doesn't work that way. So there have definitely been times when I was first in New York for that first semester, I was terrified there. I was all on my own, and it was my first real shot at doing anything. And it ended up being very good, and I met a lot of people and did some great work, learned a lot. But there were some moments where I thought, oh my god, I'm the worst actress ever. And every actor thinks that. And you just constantly have to keep going and believe in yourself and keep trying to grow and challenge and believe that you will get where you want to go with it, if you love it enough. Yes, I mean, I had a really tough time in college where I had to, I think, part of the change of committing to acting came out of really discovering who I was. I had a really bad relationship that I had to get out of, and it changed who I am. It really let me kind of create who I wanted to be, and that's how I found acting through that, and changed a lot, grew a lot, and really found what I love in this profession. And I think that that experience, although it was a terrible experience at the time, it probably brought me to being a stronger person afterward. I filled up here in New Jersey, and then I studied in New York for a little while, and now I'm beginning the MFA process. I'm applying to grad school for my acting MFA. I would say, get a coach, get in a class, constantly be doing, be stretching, be growing. Get out there and audition. Don't be afraid to be bold and take risks and believe in yourself and your talent and just continue to pursue and have fun. I hostess at a restaurant in Philadelphia, and other than that, I just really keep trying to audition and kind of all about theater. I have a lot of friends in theater here that have a good time with. Favorite movie? I'm actually a huge Audrey Hepburn fan. I'm an old movie. I love Paul Newman and Audrey Hepburn and kind of the old classic movies. So. 24. I love 24. It's awesome. Constant surprises. You're always on the edge. I love the suspense of it. There's never a dull moment. You never figure out. You think you know how it's gonna work, and it never goes that way. And I love it. It's a great show, and I love the premise of it. It just keeps you on edge. You get one week, that hour long, in real time. It's really great. I love that show. In 5 years, I would hope to have my MFA in acting, be in New York. Working, coming back to Philadelphia to do regional work as well, and just, you know, acting as often as possible, growing as an actor, becoming, challenging myself, doing harder roles and things that are more daring, and just working. That's all I want to do. I just want to keep doing it. Right now, I would love to play Tennessee Williams recently, and he's one of my favorites, and I would like to try that. I'd love to try that. Megan McDermott. I'm an actress.
Hey, hang in there. The Actors Lounge will be right back.
It came from the heart of the earth. A stone so rare, men will do anything to possess it. And all who touch it are left with blood on their hands.
Where did you bury it?
The only reason you're still alive is because you haven't told anyone where it is.
You will find it for me.
My son! Where is my son?
What if I helped you find your family? That makes us partners!
I am not your partner!
You're using him.
I'm using him, and you are using me, and this is how it works.
You're gonna steal this time.
I am his father! I must go find him!
Show us where it's hidden.
Down there, kill them all.
Give it to me.
Get him where it is. Get him.
My family, my home. I don't lost everything.
I will find you. If it takes my life.
No, honey, it's too expensive.
Please.
Actually, that's 40% off. Open box policy. Today's your lucky day, buddy.
They're lazy.
You have no idea how much planning and energy it takes to keep such a low profile.
A little slow.
Are you staring at my breasts?
I don't know.
And get no respect.
A new cashier is joining the team.
I'm Amy.
Hey.
I see you've met Zach. He's one of our box boys. Chicks always go after the alpha male like a Discovery Channel sex blaster.
But when an underachiever...
You're the lowest of the low.
Yeah, the lowest of the low.
...decides to step up.
I think she has a thing for the employee of the month.
I'll win employee of the month.
He can't do it alone.
Maybe you should listen to your loser buddies.
Who's calling me a loser?
Easy there. No need to get physical.
No, I'm serious. I can't see who's calling me a loser.
This October.
Butterbuns? She's all mine.
Wouldn't be too sure about that.
An unlikely group of heroes.
It's a go.
Clean up on aisle 313.
It's today, bitch!
Will find themselves...
Ready to do this?
Yeah.
...on the winning team.
Most guys try really hard to impress me. Something different about you.
From the producers of Wedding Crashers.
This is an 81 Honda. How dare you?
Employee of the month.
Do you know what this is?
Yes, a 10 times larger than life replica of you.
For a show at Drexel. I have been a choreographer in the past, but right now I'm just dancing, and our show is going to be at the end of January. In the future, I hope to be dancing with a company, hopefully in Philadelphia. Maybe I'll go back to Paris, I'm not sure, but that's my plan. I grew up in Bucks County, Pennsylvania. It's the suburbs outside of Philadelphia. No, my family is my mom, my dad, my two younger brothers, and five cats. Oh, growing up, I think my best experience actually had to do with dance. I was the lead in my Nutcracker at my senior year, and it's something I've been working for ever since I really started dancing. It's kind of the reason why I started. And I got the part, and it was really, really a great accomplishment for me. Other than that, I think I've done a lot of work abroad. I've worked abroad, I've studied abroad, and those are kind of things that I've just went, I've just done on my own. They're really great accomplishments and really kind of changed who I am today. Well, living abroad really just changed my whole perception of the world around me, who I am, how I fit into my world. Because before, you know, I was just a girl from the suburbs. I go to school in the city, but I kind of, you know, I never left the country. I had that small town kind of feel. And once I left, I really got a feeling of, you know, there's just so many different cultures in the world. There's so much more to see. There's so much out there than right in your own backyard. As far as performing, I am auditioning for a show with my company at school. That's my only project right now. It's going to be big. That's about it for the moment. If I could say something to maybe an up-and-coming dancer, I would just say that I know it's not always easy, especially when you're thrown in there, especially with a group of people that you don't know, that you've never danced with before, and you know, you might not get the parts that you want, you might not be doing something you love, but the most important thing is just remember why you started, remember why you dance, remember why you love it, and then it'll be easy. My name is Brittany Cormack. I'm a dancer.
Red Envelope Entertainment and IFC Films proudly present Maggie Gyllenhaal in Cherry Baby.
You. Hey, sir, you just bumped into me.
Do you understand the conditions of your parole, Miss Swanson? Any unreported police contact will result in the immediate violation of your parole, and I will violate you.
I have to see my daughter. I haven't seen her in a long time.
It'll be like you never left.
Hey, girls.
Mommy? Hi.
Where were you?
I would like to work with kids. I have a child, and I would like to become a better mother.
I'm Andy Kelly. I'm the director of this program.
Oh, hey, I'm Sherry.
Nice to meet you.
I want to welcome home Sherry Ann.
You bring drugs in here, and I'm going to call the cops.
Bobby, I'm clean.
I've got a problem with you.
I will hurt you.
Lenny told me to call you Sherry, not Mom.
She was fine until you showed up.
I'm her mother.
We'll act like one.
Get your hands on the wall now! Spread them.
Just because you can send me back to prison, you're strong.
Control yourself.
I'm strong.
Shut up.
Critics are saying Maggie Gyllenhaal is pure sizzle, a tour de force performance.
I don't know what to do. I feel like they're taking her away from me.
Gyllenhaal is an eye-opener. It sure looks like Oscar bait to me. Bravo.
Lord, forgive me my weaknesses and my mistakes. Give me the strength to take life one day at a time and take care of my daughter again. Amen.
You know what? I used to get scared, too. All the time.
Maggie Gyllenhaal. Sherry Baby, a film by Lori Collier. Coming soon to theaters everywhere.
It's all about celebrating the sound of Philadelphia by bringing, having people experience the sound of Philadelphia in their own way, by buying music, by experiencing the artifacts that we have here, seeing the pictures, seeing the visual, being able to walk away with a Sound of Love t-shirt and have that as something they can wear at home. Say that they've been to Philadelphia and really experienced the music that made them happy, that made them love, that made them feel appreciated. It goes back 35 years, and so you got a gamut of folks that go back to in the 70s to young people who hear the music sampled through the records now. So it really has a broad perspective of folks and demographics of folks who want to experience it.
Today's the grand opening of Sound of Philadelphia Souvenir Shop. Opening by Charles Gamble, and to honor legendary songwriters Kenneth Gamble and Leon Huff.
Yes. And what's your name?
My name's Kiyasha Tyson.
Okay, and where are we located?
We're located on 309 South Broad Street.
And what type of things are here?
Well, we have CDs, CDs produced and written by Kenneth Gamble and Leon Huff. We have t-shirts with PIR logo and with Patti LaBelle, Lou Ross, and Teddy Pendergrass. We also have keychains, mugs, and pins. And we're getting future merchandise. We have these jackets on the wall that you can order.
Record label was created in 1971. It was created by Kenny Gamble, Leon Huff, and it was with CBS Records and the Clive Davis, and created artists such as Patti LaBelle, Lou Rawls, Teddy Pendergrass, Stylist, and Suspenders, Jones Girls, Phyllis Hyman, and many others. Total of 37 artists. We were the biggest record label in the 70s in terms of black owned record label. We were bigger than Epic Records by 1975. We were averaging about 30 or 35 records a year on the chart. 150 number one hits, 300 top 100 hits, and 100 Billboard charts. And just had a phenomenal success in making all these artists. Our music is heard in about 14 countries. That's about every 13.5 minutes, somewhere in the world, hears a Gamble and Huff song. You hear it now on television, film, and commercials, such as Donald Trump using The Apprentice in the show The Apprentice for the love of money. You hear it on the Coors commercial using Love Train. You heard it on a Gap commercial where they use Love Train. You see it in movies such as Guess Who and Dr. Doolittle and many other movies over the years.
I work here. I'm special project coordinator. My name is Dina, and this is one of our best teachers,
Shauna Rowland,
from the Special Projects Division.
Okay. And what's this all about?
This is all about paying homage to the Sound of Philadelphia and Philly International artists, Gamble and Huff as well, to kind of keep the spirit alive and to give people a place to come to experience the Sound of Philadelphia.
It's about R&B and soul music. Our sister related company in the music world is Motown. And so if you were an artist with Motown, if you weren't with Motown, you were with us. And so we're here to celebrate 35 years of that activity of the Sound of Philadelphia. We like to expand more of our licensing activity and also to be in a position where we can really bring some good, bring some more message songs out to folks in the future.
Okay.
So we got some surprises in 2007, which we'll announce later.
Okay.
I think it's great. I'm just happy to be part of all of this, and I think this event is going to keep the Sound of Philadelphia alive.
Well, yeah, Grace Little. Grace Little's one, and we have a young pop group we're working with. And again, we have to leave everything else to 2007 because they're under wraps right now.
Okay.
Hi,
gift shop, you expect all the things you like to take as souvenirs. T-shirts, hats, cups, 45 records, albums, for those who remember that. And really to just experience it, be able to feel the Gamble Huff keyboard and piano. And then also we're going to have a sound recording booth too. You can record a record, take the CD home. Chuck Gamble, I'm Executive Vice President for Philadelphia National Records.
Make sure you come check out the Sound of Philadelphia Souvenir Shop. We're here on Broad Street and we have a lot of good merchandise for all of you. Come again.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm executive producer Tony Lankford for the Actors Lounge. If you're interested in sponsoring or advertising on the Actors Lounge, you can either give me a call at 215-253-1677 or you can email me at theactorslounge@philly1.com. That's theactorslounge@philly1.com.
Was abducted. Pamela Hughes, such a crime. As an attack on our entire corporation.
Is Alona working on something confidential?
She's working hard on improving everyone's quality of life.
I want to know everything. First we find her. Then we sleep.
Hey, thanks for dropping by the Actors Lounge. We'll see you next time.